Hello friends, after routine cataract surgeries, post-operative surprises are not uncommon. On post-operative day 1, sometimes I get really annoyed due to post-operative rise of IOP and inflammation caused by retained viscoelastic. If visco is the culprit, can we use only BSS for the surgery? Here we present our technique of viscoless phaco. Say a big no to the sticky visco. It is important to keep the anterior chamber maintained throughout the surgery. That is why side port entry is crucial. We prefer MVR blade for side port, which is removed quickly to prevent collapse of anterior chamber. We routinely use Rifamblu to stain the anterior capsule. To illustrate how visco behaves during various steps of cataract surgery, we deliberately stained a viscoelastic with Rifamblu, and we observed it is impossible to remove viscoelastic from the anterior chamber in total. Continuous irrigation is used through the left hand side port to maintain the anterior chamber and to stabilize the globe during main port entry by keratome. Here comes the real challenge of viscoless phaco surgery, the capsular excess. After stabilizing the globe with left hand, microexcess forceps is used to perform the capsular excess, keeping in mind turbulences and fluid currents of continuous irrigation in the anterior chamber. Hydrodissection is performed routinely. During nucleus management, first insert the phaco probe with irrigation on and later replace the chopper in left hand. If the phaco energy uses, direct chop was used. Nucleus was divided into fragments and they were emulsified. For irrigation and aspiration, chopper was removed first, which was replaced by irrigation probe, and then the phaco probe was removed. Through the side port, aspiration port was introduced, and then the IA was carried out. After the completion of cortical removal, IOL was inserted in the bag under the irrigation. IOL was rotated gently inside the bag with the help of dialer. Start hydrating the ports before removal of irrigation canal. Friends, let us see how difficult it is to remove viscoelastic completely at the end of the surgery. Blue flecks seen here are retained visco. Now I am fully ready to say a big no to the sticky visco.